What's going on, everybody? It is Shawn here, your local Fraser Valley real estate agent. It is gorgeous outside and my camera is sitting sideways. Yeah, that's much better. All right. I went to go and upload my video yesterday and I lost all my footage. So I'm re-recording this. And I'm gonna sum up basically some of the things that have been going on, some new things in the market, some new news. Vancouver's empty home tax and the BC government ending the first time home buyer program. Some information on that and some crazy news that I saw this morning about a strip mall that's sold in Kelowna, which just boggles my mind. I don't understand it. But before I get into everything, if this is your first time coming to my page, thank you for visiting. Make sure you do hit that subscribe button at the bottom and hit the little bell notification icon so that when I do upload a new video, you get a notification to my page. Anyways, let's go forward. I'm gonna sum everything up. And first thing I wanna answer is I've had a few people message me and say, hey, you know, Shawn, is the market slowing down? What's it doing? What's going on? What's detached homes doing? What's attached homes doing? The answer is things are steady. They're still moving. Market's not crashing. Like some people have stated, oh, it's going to crash. It's going to crash. Sky's not falling yet, guys. Things are still going. If you have lending ability to be able to grab money from your lender, if you can do it, go and do it. I suggest you go and call up your mortgage professional. If you don't have somebody that you can call or talk to, you can always reach out to me and I can direct you towards somebody or some people. You can make a decision. I'll give you a few numbers to call and you can go that route. Market is still fine. Market is still moving. Detached homes are still going up. Sale numbers are still going. Number of units are still selling. So, I mean, I don't see it slowing down anytime just yet. What happens tomorrow? Who knows? That being said, I'm gonna go back into what I was talking about, the topic of this video, the empty home tax, the first time home buyer program being ended, and so forth. So we'll start off with the home tax. I made some notes, so I'm just gonna go off of them. There's a lot of numbers. So after they did their thing, the deadline has come and gone. 183,911 homes or let's say properties declarations have been submitted. So that was about 98.8% of all that were applicable in Vancouver. That's a lot of homes, a lot of properties. Out of all those numbers, declared principal residence and declared tenanted were 177,562 occupied residential properties. That's a pretty big chunk. Unoccupied and underutilized residential properties declared, so either declared vacant, declared exempt, and undeclared slash deemed vacant. They said there was 8,481 units. That's pretty substantial. That's a lot of empty places that could be utilized right now. Undeclared residential properties, as a result of this process, they said that the numbers were 2,132. If you want to read more about this stuff, because I just kind of did the Cole's Note version of this, if you want to read more about this story, I will place a link in the description of this video for you guys to go and check. You can go do your own reading at your own leisure. But those are basically all the numbers that they had thrown out there. And I got this off of Daily Hive is what I saw it on. And I think I saw it on another news channel, and I just picked up the Daily Hive because all the numbers were kind of just summed up. So as far as other news, I was kind of surprised at the numbers that they threw out for the government ending the first time home buyers program. I had a lot of clients who use this program, but now they're ending it as of this month, March 31st, they're closing down this program. But they are gonna use the funding that they were gonna use for this program, they're gonna redirect it towards another funding, which is, another program, which I think is gonna be wonderful. Apparently they've already started this program. It's already well underway. So I'm gonna get into that. So like I said, program's ending on March 31st, and that's the BC government's ending the first time home buyer program. The so things to remember is the end date, applications received by the end date, they're still gonna consider those applications. So if you have time before the end of this month, you still have time. Like, don't panic. Current recipients of this program will not be affected. So, like I said, don't panic. So this program, they anticipated that they would be able to provide 42,000 loans for a 3-year period. However, that kind of fell on its face, and that didn't happen. So as of January 31st of this year, there was fewer than 3,000 loans that were actually provided and approved, which is nowhere near the 42,000 loans that they were talking about. So that was the bad news about them closing it down. But the good news is the funds that they have remaining that they were going to use for this program, they're being redirected to a agency called the Housing Hub. So at first I was kind of like, okay, this is just gonna be another thing where somebody's just gonna take the government's money and run with it. But anyways, it doesn't seem that way. So what they're doing is this agency called the Housing Hub, they're gonna be targeting household income, average incomes between $50,000 to $100,000, and they're gonna allow people to buy these homes, but you gotta show your income between $50,000 to $100,000, depending on the area that they're building in. Some projects are already underway. There's two projects that were mentioned in the report. One was the Little Mountain project, and I believe that one's in Vancouver. And there's another one called the Cedar Place, and I believe that one's in Burnaby. Don't hold me on that one. But like I said, I'm gonna provide links, so you guys can definitely go check it out. It'll be in the description. Other than that, that's pretty much the news that I have. So last but not least, it was the last thing I wanted to talk about, because I don't want to make a huge deal out of it, but it still boggles my mind as to what the hell. $85 million. $85 million for a strip mall. Now, I don't know the exact details. I didn't want to even look into it. But it's, apparently it's called the Dilworth Center. It's 14 acres along Highway 97 out in Kelowna. Boggles my mind. Don't know what they're going to really do with it. It just says that an investing group purchased it. I'm gonna put a link to this. You can read it at your own leisure. It boggles my mind that investors would spend such a bullish amount on a parcel of land. I understand it's an income-making property, it's a commercial-grade property, but keep this video short. If this is your first time coming, I really do appreciate you coming by. I thank everybody for their time. If you like the content, you liked the information that I gave you, do please hit that like button, the thumbs up. There's a thumbs up at the bottom, just go click it, give me a thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button right to the side of the subscribe, the bell notification. And thank you for coming by, thank you for stopping by. If you have any comments, you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. I will look at the comment section. If anybody has any questions, you can place your questions in the comments, or you can message me directly. Very easy to get a hold of me. Go to my website and shoot me a message from there. Once again, thanks for stopping by, and see you guys later.